ඒකයි බය නැතුව මම නොකිය ඇන්ඩ්‍රොයිඩ් ස්මාර්ට් ෆෝන් එක ඕන කෙනෙකුට ගන්න කියන්නේ.
හැමදා අලුත් වෙන නොකියා.
Presidential candidate of the New Democratic Front, Minister Sajit Premadasa, launched his much-awaited election manifesto today at a ceremony organized in Kandy. Titled, There is no limit to what Sri Lanka can achieve, let us prove it together, under the theme Sajit's Social Revolution, the manifesto reveals plans of the presidential hopeful for the next 5 years.
විවිධ බලවේග විවිධ පාර්ශ්ව කරුවන් අභ්‍යන්තර න්‍යාය පත්‍රයට ඇඟිලි ගසන්නට උත්සාහ දරන කාලවකවානුවකදී මම ඍජුව ප්‍රතිඥාවක් දෙනවා. අපේ රටේ ඒකීය භාවය, ස්වෛරීත්වය, බහුමික අඛණ්ඩතාවය, දේශපාලන නිදහස, සම්බුද්ධ ශාසනයට මුල්තැන ලබා දෙමින් සෙසු ආගම්, සෙසු ජාතීන් සුරක්ෂා කරමින් ජනතා පරමාධිපත්‍ය රජවන මාතෘභූමිය අපි නිර්මාණය කරනවායි කියන එක මේ අවස්ථාවේ ප්‍රකාශ කරනවා. මේ ගමනේ ප්‍රධානතම ඉලක්කය අපේ මාතෘභූමිය සෞභාග්‍ය සම්පන්න දේශයක් බවට නිර්මාණය කිරීමයි. මේ රටේ ත්‍රස්තවාදය තුළින් පවුලේ සමාජිකින් අහිමි වුණු පවුල්වල ඒ දුක කඳුල වේදනාව මම හොඳින් අවබෝධ කරගෙන තිබෙනවා. ත්‍රස්තවාදය පරාජය කරපු ඒ සෙන්පතිවරුන් සියලු දෙනා ජාතික ආරක්ෂා වගකීම වෙත යොමු කරලා ඒ නායකත්වය ලබා දීලා ත්‍රස්තවාදය මුලිනුපුටා දමපු දේශයක් බවට අපි නිර්මාණය වෙනවා. අපි එක්ව ඉදිරියට ගිහිල්ලා මේ රටේ සියලුම දෙනා එකතු කරගත් ශ්‍රේ෷්ඨ රටක් නිර්මාණය කරමු.
The manifesto focuses on various arenas, with focal points being affordable prices and a high quality of life, shelter for all, universal preschool for all, universal higher education, universal healthcare, accountable leadership, zero tolerance on drugs and corruption, zero tolerance on religious extremism and violence, a tough and a smart national security strategy, dignity for the public sector, government for the people, financial markets, inspiring women, empowering small businesses, empowering the farmer, environment and energy, encouraging entrepreneurship and innovation, a market-ready youth population, appreciation of migrant workers, and public transport. In his manifesto, the presidential candidate has paid special attention to the illicit drug elimination, where he says his administration will establish a special anti-narcotics court, special anti-narcotics prosecutor, and strengthen the police anti-narcotics division. It goes on to highlight that new laws and regulations under which religious extremism may be monitored, investigated, and prosecuted where necessary. These laws will also place severe penalties on hate speech and misinformation. The presidential hopeful goes on to emphasize that public services will be reformed into a people-centric administration, which will be staffed according to merit and not by favoritism or corruption. Focusing on his efforts against terrorism, Premadasa says that he will develop a holistic and a long-term national security strategy with the attention on counter-terrorism and preventing violent extremism. A post by the name National Security Advisor will be created along with the establishment of a new inter-organizational counter-terrorism center, which will hold weekly meetings. The administration also hopes to create a new National Intelligence Act to increase efficiency in intelligence gathering and enable coordination between intelligence agencies. Minister Premadasa also hopes to engage in a constitutional reform process on the executive president, acting with the concurrence of the Prime Minister. He says devolution and electoral systems launched by this parliament will be completed without delay, along with all stakeholders, and that the new constitution will be approved through a referendum. Focusing on his foreign policy, Premadasa says that strong relations will be built with neighbouring countries to project Sri Lanka's role in the hub of the Indian Ocean Rim regions. The manifesto mentions that Sri Lanka's foreign services will be reoriented to focus more on economic diplomacy and that all diplomatic missions will be regularly evaluated on contribution to national interests as well as trade and investment promotion. The presidential hopeful also gives his guarantee on ensuring media freedom by abolishing outdated laws in accordance with Colombo Declaration on Media Freedom and Social Responsibility. He promises to remove the carbon tax on vehicles, while higher investment for the modernization of public transport will be financed by taxing land appreciation. In an attempt to encourage entrepreneurship, the presidential candidate hopes to provide tax relief and improve ease of doing business for small and medium enterprises by increasing the value-added tax threshold from 12 million rupees per year to 50 million rupees per year, removing the need for businesses to earn up to 4 million rupees a month to pay VAT. A 10 million rupee national venture capital fund will also be created to support tech startups. The recently passed anti-dumping law will also be strengthened to protect the SMEs from unfair trade practices. Premadas also says that all state-owned enterprises will be required to publish audited accounts on a quarterly basis, similar to publicly quoted companies listed in the Colombo Stock Exchange. The election manifesto goes on to say that in order to achieve an export-driven growth, the new administration will swiftly implement the national export strategy. Focusing on his proposed tax system, Premadasa notes that contribution from indirect taxes will be reduced by 60%, relieving the poorest taxpayers in society. In bringing down the number of taxes, the new administration hopes to amalgamate the NBT and VAT to a single tax of 15%. Premadas also hopes to immediately implement the capital depreciation allowance, under which all investments up to $100 million will receive an additional 100% capital allowance in addition to 100% depreciation. Investments of over $150 million will receive an additional capital allowance of 150%. In his designs for the tourism sector, Premadasa says that he will create public-private partnerships between the government and the private sector to manage funds from Tourism Development Levy and establish a one-stop shop for tourism sector regulatory agencies. He also pledges special incentives for setting up entertainment parks, adventure-based tourism and MICE tourism. He further hopes to make destination marketing campaign a high priority in key source markets such as India, China and Southeast Asia. Premadasa notes that brand of Sri Lanka will be promoted in collaboration with Sri Lanka Tourism, Sri Lankan Airlines and Ceylon Tea. The presidential candidate says that two presidential task forces will be appointed for reconstruction and development in the northern and eastern provinces. A presidential commission will also be appointed to address the outstanding land disputes in the conflict-affected areas, with the plan of solving these issues within a year. He also promises to release all those who were detained for long periods of time without charges. Premadasa, meanwhile, extends his fullest support for the Office of Missing Persons and Office of Reparations. Moving on to his promises on the issues faced by the people in the upcountry, Premadasa says that a presidential task force to uplift the upcountry community will immediately be established. He promises the upcountry people their own 7-perch freehold plot of land with a home. He also reiterates his hopes of facilitating a 1,500 rupee per day income for estate workers, along with efforts to revive health and education privileges of the upcountry. Noting the importance of youth participation in the decision-making process, the presidential contender promises to institutionalize diverse youth representation in public policy consultations at all levels of the government. He also hopes to establish a 15 billion rupee fund to create 100,000 jobs for the youth in the export sector.
Maxis, number one tie in Sri Lanka.